Hey guys, welcome to Best Movie Recap. Today I'm going to explain a 2022 American action movie called Samaritan. Warning! Spoilers ahead, watch out and take care. The movie begins with a 13-year-old boy named Sam Cleary telling the story of two superpowered twin brothers. As children, they were bullied and called freaks for their super strength, as they had hurt people unintentionally. People in town set fire to the boy's home, killing their parents in the process. One brother grew up to become the hero Samaritan, while the other became a revenge-drive villain called Nemesis. One day, Nemesis forged a powerful hammer and lured Samaritan to a power plant where they engaged in an infamous battle where both of them seemingly died. However, Sam believes that Samaritan is still out there. Sam lives in Granite City with his mother Tiffany, who is a nurse trying to make ends meet. The two are struggling with money to the point that Tiffany takes money from Sam for the bus. One day, after coming back from school, Sam notices eviction papers left by his apartment and the door sealed. While waiting outside for his mother, his friend bullies him and coerces him into making easy money. The idea of earning quick cash excites Sam, so he joins his friend Jace to steal copper wire from an abandoned building and sell it off to some guy in an old junkyard owned by the local crime boss Cyrus, but they make only $40. They are approached by a street gang working for Cyrus. Reza, one of the gang members, offers the boys a chance to make real money by causing a distraction while they rob a local convenience store. Jace refuses the offer, but Sam volunteers. The group goes to the store, where Sam makes a mess in the store pretending to have gotten hit by a car while the gang members steal what they think are lottery ticket boxes. When they get back to Cyrus, his goons see that they're just bags of potato chips. Reza tries to lie and blame Sam, but Sam blurts out the truth. Before Reza can antagonize him, Cyrus and his right-hand woman Syl show up, with Cyrus complimenting Sam over Reza. Sam also sees that Cyrus is a follower of Nemesis, as he believed that he fought for people in his own way. When Cyrus goes through Sam's scrapbook, which has a lot of references and drawings of the twins, he explains why he likes the evil brother Nemesis over the good one. Then he rewards Sam for not snitching on his people and for what he will do for him in the future. Sam returns home with his cut of the money and gives it to Tiffany so she can give it to the landlord to let them keep staying in their apartment. Tiffany knows that Sam got it through dishonest means, and warns him about doing so. Meanwhile, Cyrus and his crew get their hands on some new weapons to use for their next mission. On the other hand, Granite City is dying due to unemployment and poverty. City people are slowly succumbing to the cost of living, and it has become impossible to survive with the rising crime rate. Cyrus is taking advantage of the city's ongoing situation. He builds an army of people, brainwashing them with his selfish propaganda and telling lies that he will save them from their sufferings. The next day, while Reza was playing table football, he noticed Sam, who was passing by. Reza and his buddies chased after Sam due to Reza being humiliated by Cyrus and because he want the money Sam got from Cyrus. While running from the bully, Sam almost got hit by a bus, and his neighbor Joe saw that Sam is in trouble. Reza and his crew catch Sam and they start to attack and beat him up, but they are spotted by Sam's neighbor Joe. With his incredible strength, he throws the other two goons off of Sam, then he throws Reza too, who grabs his knife and tries to stab Joe, who damages the knife with his bare hand and not bleeding. With this, Sam is convinced that Joe is really Samaritan. Later on that night, Cyrus, Syl, and their other henchmen wear like police officers and use their weapons to break into a warehouse, after killing the guard there with a blackout bomb. Then Cyrus finds the mask of Nemesis, as well as the hammer he used to fight Samaritan. Joe appears to sense when the hammer's power is activated and used to crush the mask of the Samaritan. Meanwhile, Sam visits an author named Albert Kassler, who wrote a book on Samaritan and Nemesis. Sam insists that Joe is Samaritan, but Albert has been annoyed because Sam always pesters him when he thinks he has found someone who might be Samaritan. After enough badgering, Albert shows Sam his room with his own theories on the superhero and says how Nemesis's hammer was found at the site of the power plant, believing that Nemesis wanted to throw the city into chaos and kill his brother, but this led to his own death. Sam later sneaks into Joe's apartment for more proof. He finds a scrapbook full of newspaper clippings about Samaritan heroics. He took it and leaves. Joe comes back home and realizes that his scrapbook is missing. Then he directly visits Sam's house and reveals to his mother what he did. Sam gives back the scrapbook and apologized, and Joe forgives him after talking with his mother. They go outside, where Sam tries to get Joe to admit to who he really is, but Joe is not having it. Reza and his goons then drive their car to hit Joe as payback for him beating them up. Sam runs to Joe, who looks badly injured, but then appears to quickly heal his bones. Sam goes with Joe back inside his apartment, where he continues to deny that he is Samaritan, and he eats loads of ice cream to keep his body cooled down. Meanwhile, Cyrus and his crew use the hammer to begin creating destruction around the city. He dubs himself the new nemesis and rallies several impoverished citizens to support him. On the other side, Joe had nightmares of the fight between him and Nemesis. He then becomes angered at the thought of Nemesis making a comeback in the news, but he continues to hang out with Sam and show him that using his strength is not necessary. He can solve his daily problem as a normal person without a need for fights. Then he tells him many things about his power and why he is no longer using it. They become really close, like a father and his son. Then Joe offered to fix Sam's broken watch. The next morning, Sam asks Joe to teach him how to fight and he accepts. The two meet up on the rooftop of the building. And the training starts, but Sam tries to punch Joe and ends up hurting his arm. After that, Sam rejoins Cyrus and his crew over lunch, but he becomes fearful when he sees that they took in a crooked cop and beat him up for messing with their plans. Cyrus appears to let him go, only to shoot the man in the back as he is running, which Sam witnesses. As Sam runs away, he finds Reza and his goons attacking Jace. Sam fights them off but gets himself beaten up again and sent to the hospital. Tiffany admonishes Joe when he shows up there for not defending Sam. Cyrus's goons follow Joe to try and beat him up, only for him to wipe the floor with all of them. In the chaos, a little girl witnesses everything and approaches Joe. One of the goons then throws a grenade at Joe, so he grabs the little girl and flips a car over to shield them from the explosion. Witnesses now also believe that Samaritan really is back. Cyrus finds out and becomes enraged since it means his plans may be stopped. Later on that day, Sam goes to Joe to warn him about what Cyrus is planning to do, but Joe chooses to stay out of it. Cyrus and his crew storm Joe's apartment and open fire, but they don't find him. They then run to the next building to go after Sam. He gets Tiffany to run with him to the rooftop, but Syl corners them at the fire escape while the other goons surround them. Sam gets a good hit against Reza, but Cyrus orders his men to take Sam, knowing that it will lead Samaritan right to them. In the train station, Joe checks his pocket and finds Sam's watch, which he fixed but forgets to give it back to him. Joe returns to the building but only to find Tiffany wounded. Then she tells him what happened to her and who took Sam. Meanwhile, Cyrus brings Sam to a factory where he wants to finish what Nemesis started. Joe drives a truck there and crashes through the building. Then he starts fighting and killing the thugs. At this moment, Cyrus shows up with Sam, and Joe asks Cyrus to let Sam go and fight him, but Cyrus rages out and starts beating Joe with a hammer. Then Sam starts screaming for Joe to use his power and fight back. It turns out that Joe is really not Samaritan, but he was actually Nemesis. A flashback shows that Nemesis actually tried to save his brother, but he fell to his death in the fire, and Joe quit being a villain for his brother's sake. Joe has already set a bomb in the truck, which goes off, killing some of Cyrus's crew, including Syl. Joe fights the surviving goons before his showdown with Cyrus. He overpowers Cyrus and bends the hammer's handle around Cyrus to trap him before throwing him to his death. Joe's body overheats, so Sam sprays him with water before his heart stop and he die. Then they run out. Sam is in disbelief that Joe was really Nemesis. When Sam questions him why he killed Cyrus, Joe replies that getting rid of bad people for doing bad things is easier. However, the truth is to make the right choice by following one's heart, because everyone has good and evil in them. Realizing the reality that Joe mentioned, Sam goes outside to be greeted by paramedics, a news crew, and other citizens. Police arrest Reza and his buddies. Sam declares that it was Samaritan who showed up and saved him from the evil goons. As the crowd cheers, Sam and Joe smile at each other before Joe walks away into the night, and his identity remains anonymous.